All right, stuff I like.
Stuff I like.
David Shorten. He's a well-named person. Shorten. It was very short. So yesterday, along with the Ben Rhodes video, which did make me laugh uproariously in an unkind and almost inhuman way, almost demonic if you think about it, there was another video of a boy, an eight-year-old boy named Maurice Adams Jr. down in Georgia, who was passing by and saw an elderly lady trying to get up a flight of stairs with her walker. Couldn't you play it and leave my mic on? Just play the vid and leave my mic on. They're playing music, but he basically helps her get up the stairs with this video. And he doesn't know he's being filmed, which is kind of a beautiful thing about it. And I'm watching this thing and I'm thinking, there is a man. Obviously, he's a little man. One day he'll be a big man, but he is a man inside and he has the makings of a really good man. And the thing that gets me about this is that when you see feminists praising people like Amy Schumer and Samantha Bee, for the kind of filth that comes out of their mouths. I've heard feminists say this again and again, where they say, oh, they're empowered because they're doing what men do. They're talking the kind of filth that men do. And now it's very empowering because now men have the power. So men are talking filth. And so now these women have the power. But men who talk like that are thugs. They're oafs. They're not men. This is what a man is. So if a feminist wants to be like a man, maybe she should run into a burning building and carry someone out of it or help an old lady across the street. Then you're empowered. Then you're being like the best of men. And I think this is what the left does all the time. They adapt the principles of their enemies. And so they oftentimes achieve their enemies' goals. I mean, they'll say, oh, well, the racists have all the power. So now we're going to be against white people. So we'll be the racist and we'll be powerful like the racists before. But of course, all you do is you extend the crime of racism and extend all the bad things that come with it. I'm off to Knowles' wedding. By the time I see you next, this is a true Clavenless weekend because by the time this weekend is over, if I can't figure out a way to stop it, Knowles will be married. I hope this doesn't mean he's going to reproduce. Oh my Lord. The mind boggles. I'll do what I can, folks, but it's the Clavenless weekend. I can only do so much. Survivors gather back here on Monday. Here is Billie Holiday with my message to the troops. I'll be back then. I'm Andrew Claven. This is The Andrew Claven Show.
In all the old familiar places that this heart of mine embraces all day through. Across the way, the children's carousel, the chestnut trees, the wishing well.
The Andrew Claven Show is produced by Robert Sterling. Executive producer, Jeremy Boring. Senior producer, Jonathan Hay. Our supervising producer is Mathis Glover. And our technical producer is Austin Stevens. Edited by Emily Jai. Audio is mixed by Mike Cormina. Hair and makeup is by Jesua Alvera. The Andrew Claven Show is a Daily Wire Forward Publishing production. Copyright Forward Publishing 2018.